Margo says, hi, Andrew. As you know, I have been working with real estate niche. I'm not getting volume. I'm thinking to add peer contractors, designers, women-owned businesses to bring in heavier volume. Thoughts? So what I would say is, if you're in the real estate niche, right, instead of going to designers, or what was the other one here, designers and contractors, I would try to think about, okay, if I'm in the niche of real estate, what does that really mean first? If I'm in the niche of real estate, okay, and then in that niche of real estate, are we talking about agents? Are we talking about agents? Are we talking about brokers? Are we talking about property managers? Are we talking about developers? Are we talking about investors? Right, these are some of the major categories of people in the real estate space. So you wanna be like, whenever you think about niche and as you go further down and you think about changing your targeting on LinkedIn or on Facebook advertising, you wanna be very clear. You know, I'm helping a friend of mine. He's doing 3 or 4 million a year in sales, and he's got a great company, 3 or 4 million a month, sorry, in sales. So he's doing 30, 40 million a year. And he's got a great company, and he's done a lot of great stuff, and he's actually starting a separate business. And so I was giving him some advice and whatnot, and I was talking about picking a niche and how that's been super valuable and important for me and everybody here. And I was saying, you know, when you pick a niche, every single word when you describe that niche matters, okay? So when you say real estate, you know, you gotta be real specific. Like, who is in your niche? And then within each of these, there's also subcomponents, right? So if you think about agents, there's people that are interested in getting in, but have no license, like, because you have to have a license to be a real estate agent, from my knowledge. Interested in getting in, people that started but are doing zero in sales, right? So they actually don't, they've started, they're doing it like full-time or almost full-time, but they don't actually have even one client that they've won or any money that they've made from this. And then you have people that are doing sort of zero to 100K, you have people that are doing 100 to 500, and you have people that are doing 500 to a million, right? And all these people are just agents, so that's just agents, right? Not to mention you go into brokers, property managers, developers, investors, and there's all sorts of things like in investors, there's like, okay, are they commercial, are they residential? Like, so you wanna be, if you're thinking about widening your niche, you first wanna get really clear about what the niche is, and then when you widen it, I would first rather widen it up the tree rather than like jumping to something else completely or jumping to a completely different niche, like designers. Right, designers. So I would try to widen it to something that's as close to this as possible rather than going to like medical practices or something. And that would be more like evolving the niche. You know, I always talk about evolving the niche as opposed to changing it. You want to be somebody that evolves the niche, doesn't completely change it. So first, in Margo's case in particular, I want to get really clear about who it is, and then I want to think about evolving it and seeing if we can widen it that way so I do get some sort of bump, but I don't have to completely change my message, people don't get confused.